folks doing that. In fact, let me show you this photo we just got right there. I love that picture behind Dan, the hazy sunshine. Mike Brevard County, Sapinski, that is. He's over there. He's enjoying the beautiful afternoon there, and I'm sure he's getting ready for that nighttime show coming up around 8:29, hopefully, at the beginning of our window. Let's take a look now at what's going on out there. East Coast sea breeze, anvil clouds have worked inland away from the pad, but there are some showers popping up. Those will hopefully lift out way before the 8 o'clock hour. Otherwise, we are talking about a few showers up here over towards Ocala and Redick. A few heavier showers and storms now pulling out of Sumter County and out of Bushnell, which is certainly some good news. Just watch your travels over 75 over about the next half hour. And then here, all of a sudden, we've had a little bit of a merger here with an outflow boundary and a shower. It's kind of producing a heavier shower right now over towards Lockhart. Not seeing any lightning in there, but it's all drifting off towards the south and the west. So Winter Garden, Ocoee, get ready for that. It's going to be headed your way. Windermere, Dr. Phillips, a couple of showers here. This one now falling apart. And that big cluster of storms that was down across southern Osceola County, thankfully falling apart. Still a few heavier showers east of Poinciana, but here's a look at some of those offshore showers. They're few and far in between there, but again, if they were to meander back more towards the west, that could be a problem. We can't have anvil clouds and we can't have any rain in the area. We don't think we will. In fact, we think things are going to die down right around 8 o'clock over towards the eastern side of the peninsula. 85 rain cooled up towards Ocala. Still a sizzling 90 degrees in downtown Orlando. Over towards the coast, great place to be with that onshore flow. The gust of 20 to 25 making it feel at least a little bit better than what we're feeling here through the interior. Any storms will be well west of Orlando before 9 o'clock. And then as we take a look at these overnight lows, 74 up towards Ocala, middle and upper 70s back towards the Barrier Islands. There's what Futurecast is doing, taking all that energy back towards the west and hinting at a few offshore showers near the Kennedy Space Center. So we'll keep tabs on that, give you the update right through 6:30. And then by noontime tomorrow, here comes that East Coast sea breeze working quickly inland. Overall coverage of showers and storms tomorrow, just a tick lower, coming in at about 30%. Forecast highs tomorrow, villages 92, Claremont coming in at 93, Ocala 92. Back towards the interior, Longwood over towards Winter Park and Winter Garden, 93 degrees should about do it. Then back east towards Palm Bay and Cocoa, look for your afternoon high up around 89 degrees. The beaches will be the place to be as we take a look at that forecast. Surf temperature 76 to 79. Air temperatures 88 to 90. Just watch that onshore flow. The rips will be building the next couple days. A little weak low there east of the Lesser Antilles, but upper level wind shear and dry air will mean the demise of any sort of a tropical development, which we are not expecting now over the next 5 to 7 days, at least through the eastern Caribbean. Now, as we take a look at that weekend forecast, rain chances are going to be on the lower side. The heat's going to be running near 93, 94.